What's good, y'all? Rich Sosa back in the building with another banger, man. So as you can see by the looks of the title and the screen, today I'm going to be bringing y'all a very special Lockdown Defender build. Going to be called the Multi-Position Defender. And also on top of all that, with this build, we're going to be able to get contact dunks. So before we get any further, man, I just want to say thank God for giving me this opportunity. Thank y'all for your support. And man, y'all already know what y'all need to do. Be sure to hit that sub button if you're new. Anybody looking to join the Rich Gang family, be sure to go ahead and turn on post notifications as well as hit that like button. I would appreciate it if we can get at least 50 likes on this video. Be sure to share it with your family and friends. And now, let's go ahead and get into the making of this build. So, the very first thing that you want to go ahead and do when it comes down to this build is put it under the power forward position. That is going to be the absolute best way to go about making this build, as well as if you want to be able to get the same build name but also contact dunks with it. Now, with the pie chart that we're going to go ahead and pick, you actually have a few different pie charts that you will be able to get this exact same build name out of. But also, when it comes down to getting the contact dunks, there's only going to be one pie chart that you can pick, and it's going to be the one right here, split right down the middle, with the shooting as well as the finishing. And the fact that we're still going to be able to maintain the build name that we want, as well as use the pie chart that we are using, really blows my mind. Because honestly, this build is going to be really well-rounded when it comes down to it, especially with the physical profile. We're going to go with the one with a 66 speed, 63 acceleration, 54 vertical, and a 75 strength. Now, let's go ahead and get into the breakdown of the actual build for the attributes and badges. We're going to go ahead and start off with the finishing. Close shot, going to be an 87. Driving dunk, going to go up to a 75. And our post look is going to go up to an 88. Now, right there, we get 16 finishing badges. And when it comes down to the shooting, you're also going to be able to get a good setup here as well. So, you're going to go with the mid-range shot of 74, three-pointer of a 79, and post fade of an 87. And we're going to get another 16 shooting badges on this build. For the playmaking, we're going to go with the ball handle maxed out. Same thing for the post control. Then when it comes down to it, you're going to end up with 10 playmaking badges on this build. And that is pretty much all you're going to need when it comes down to this side of the ball. But now, when it comes down to the defensive end, we're going to go with an interior defense of 69. Now, when it comes down to the perimeter defense, I'm going to go ahead and put this exactly to a 58. As for the lateral quickness, I decided to go ahead and put this to a 58 as well. Now, when it comes down to the steal, I'm going to go with the 63. Block, going to be a 73. And then as for the defensive rebound, I'm going to go ahead and put this to a 72 to leave it all is. And as you can see, we're going to end up with 7 defensive badges. Now, if you want to, you can change anything about the build if you want to go ahead and try to get extra badges in certain areas. For me though, however, this is really going to be an offensive heavy build. Not to mention, you're also going to be able to get some pretty good takeovers out of this. Don't worry, all of these stats are going to change once we get into the breakdown of the height, weight, and wingspan. So, when it comes down to the body shape, I'm going to go with built, but you can also go with burly if you want. That's another really good one. Now, when it comes down to the height, we're not going to go with 6'8", 6'9", but we're going to go with 6'7". And as you can see, we get a huge boost to a majority of our stats, and more so especially for the physicals. Now, as for the weight, instead of going with the lowest, I'm going to go ahead and put this somewhere in the 270 range. For me, I would really say this build is definitely going to be very helpful on the inside, especially with the strength that we're going to be getting on this build. I'm going to go with the weight of 274. For my preference, that is really going to be perfect. And as you can see, with the wingspan broadened altogether, if you max it out, you're going to get that 81 driving dunk, then the plus 4 at 99 overall. And from there, you're going to be able to get the contact dunks that we wanted. Now, a little thing to consider about this build, you could actually go with multiple different wingspans. So, if you want to go with anything other than the Max, you can definitely do that. And as you can see, you're going to be able to get the build name that you want. We do get the multi-position defender name, and I love the comparison of LeBron James. But now, let's just really go ahead and check out what you can do with this build, because I'm telling you, there are going to be multiple ways that you can go about it when it comes down to making this build. I really just want to go ahead and show y'all what I'm talking about. So as you can see, I did do one tick different on the wingspan, and we still are able to maintain the build name. The only difference is the contact dunks, if you will be unlocking them or not. So I would highly recommend just going with the Max. Then when it comes down to the takeover, we get the post scoring and the sharp shooting. I'm going to go with the sharp shooting. And as y'all can see, we have made the best multi-position defender build in all of 2K. Now we're going to go ahead and check out what this build is going to be looking like. Once we go ahead and max it out, all that good stuff, remember, you're going to be buying boost, which is going to give you a +4 off rip. Then if you also run with teammates that are going to be running floor general as well as defensive leader and Hall of Fame, that's another +4, so +10 in total. Then if you add in your sharpshooting takeover, you're essentially getting in +18 to your shooting. So mid-range shot and the three-pointer both will be in the 90s. Now you're gonna get a 99 post fade. If you decided to go with the post scoring on this build, your close shot will be a 99. Same thing for the post fade, still post hook will be a 99. Driving dunk has the potential to go up as well. And just know, once you hit that range in order to get the contact dunks around 86, 85, and 84, you're definitely going to be able to unlock the animations without even equipping them. You're definitely going to be able to see that you will be able to get contact dunks in takeover as well as with the boost added. I'm just letting y'all know, because a lot of people don't know about some of these things, and I really want to put y'all on just so that way you can go about it and make builds based off your own preference and use what I have given you already. But now we also get a +8 to this build when it comes down to the physicals. And not to mention, you also get a +1 badge for some of the seasons that we have completed. So that is really going to be helpful when it's all said and done. This is a super solid build all around as well, especially more so when you consider the fact that you're going to be able to do everything when it comes down to the defensive end all the way to the offensive. Now let's go ahead and get into the breakdown of these badges. There's definitely going to be a few different ways that you can go about it, but I'm just going to go ahead and get y'all started with what I think will be the best. So for the defensive end, I'm going to spread the wealth, but you can definitely switch this up to base it off of your preference. For me, I'm going to go with the rebound chaser, rim protector, clamps, hustler, interceptor, intimidator, and chase down artist. But if you were to change it, I would highly recommend upgrading some tiers of the badges that are shown here. Now let's go ahead and get into the playmaking. We get 10 badges that we're going to be able to work with here as well. So to start it off, I'm going to go with one of the most important badges. That's going to be triple threat juke, but you can definitely switch this up to go with quick first step instead. Then you can go ahead and add in gold hyperdrive as well as quick chain. Now for the very last one, this comes down to what you want to do, but I'm going to go with unpluckable on bronze. Now let's go ahead and get into the next set of badges. So as you can see, for the shooting, we actually get 16 badges, which is going to be really helpful for us. Now let's go ahead and get into the breakdown. So just remember, you can always base this off of how you want to go about it. But for me, I'm going with blinders on Hall of Fame, hot zone hunter, as well as sniper. Then I'm going to split it for silver, corner specialist, as well as Deadeye. Now let's go ahead and get into the very last part about this build, which is going to be the finishing. So we get 16 badges that we're going to be able to work with. For me, I'm going with posterizer on Hall of Fame, and another one that I really like is going to be slithery finisher. If you want to change it up though, you can definitely do that. I would go with limitless takeoff for sure. Go ahead and take off your slithery finisher. I would go ahead and put on unstrippable. That is definitely one of the best badges that you can throw on. But if you feel like splitting it between unstrippable and slithery finisher, that is definitely another way that you can go about it. For the last couple of badges, I would highly recommend going with Hall of Fame fearless finisher. That is the setup that I would be running with. And as you can see, we get 16 finishing, 16 shooting, 10 playmaking, and 7 defensive. Again, I just gotta say thank God for giving me this opportunity. Thank y'all for your support. I love y'all and I appreciate y'all. I got bangers dropping dropping this week. So, man, y'all already know what y'all need to do. Be sure to hit that sub button if you're new. Anybody looking to join the Rich Gang family, RGF, go ahead and turn on post notifications as well as hit that like button. I would appreciate it if we can get at least 50 likes on this video. Be sure to share it with your family and friends. And last but not least, with all that being said, I got one last thing to say. Rich out.